Thank you, Kevin. Thank you, Dimitri. Your mother should be very proud of you. That was a great lecture. I also want to thank the LSE Alumni Association, Maria Tsitaki, for this invitation. It's a great honor to be here. And, you know, while I was sitting there, I thought, this is great. I mean, no other university has produced so many finance ministers and prime ministers in these countries, with obvious results, I would add, but, you know, I would, I wouldn't go any further on that. I met Kevin 10 years ago, and I remember when Kevin wrote a great piece in Kathmerini about the art of following up in government. And I always thought that was a very big thing. That's something that was really missing from the art of governing here in Greece. And then this mysterious thing happened. I think George Papandreou, he was in opposition, and he called up Kevin, and he wanted to know more about follow-up. And he invited Kevin. Kevin became an advisor. Well, you know what happened? I will not pin it on the LSE or on Kevin, you know, the rest of the history. But at any rate, it was a great thing because Kevin, I think, was the first one who touched upon a very practical issue that a lot of us tend to sort of ignore. I mean, we tend to be very blasé about these kind of issues, you know, how things are organized, the staffing plans, and so on. We think those are things are very trivial. We'll talk about politics, communication, and so on. But very rarely we talk about the real, if you want, bolts and nuts of how, you know, governments are run. And I think that's a big mistake. I think this is a great book, and I didn't say it because of what you said in your introduction. I think the historical part of the book is especially strong. I found very few things missing from there. One thing I think you were, you know, seduced by Petros Moligiatis, who is a good friend, and he told you, he convinced you that he had no influence on policy or politics. And he's an old man, but he still knows how to be underestimated, which is a great, you know, tool, as you know, a great technique. I remember one prime minister I met some years ago when he was in opposition. And I asked him, how are you going to prepare for Maximo? You know, what are your plans? Oh, he said, don't worry, you know, I've talked to so-and-so, and he's going to hire a lot of cousins and nephews of our inner staff to man, you know, from the switchboards to, like, the policy advisory positions. I said, you must be kidding me. He said, no, it's all about trust. Εμπιστοσύνη, παιδί μου. And I think this is something which is apparent in the book. It's, like, very, very, very problematic, if you want. Now, the book touches upon an issue which, in my opinion, is critical. A lot of people have written about this, like my classmate Dimitris Sotiropoulos, which is the fact that Greece has a very weak civil service. That was not always the case. I think this was a result of the Junta years and then of this, what I call the tsunami of populism of the 80s. I remember hearing, you know, stories from older politicians who were telling me that when the old man, when Kostadinos Karamanlis was the prime minister, he would go to a ministry or he would go to visit a site of a public work, he wouldn't address the minister, he would address the director general of the ministry because he thought he was in charge of the file, he knew what was happening, and the minister was just there, was just another politician. Those days are long gone. As you know, we don't have the general directors, you know, we used to have. I think the civil service has weakened a lot, and that's a big problem, and we're paying a price for it. And what happened, of course, is that prime ministers and ministers more and more started relying on so-called advisors or party people, people who were not screened, who were not trained, who were not, you know, checked for anything. And less civil servants played, you know, a role in all of this. I think that one thing that is not clear in the book, and in my opinion is very important, is the real Achilles heel of the Greek state, which is management of crisis management. I mean, when you look at the recent history, you will see that, you know, the Greek state almost implodes, collapses, when there's a real crisis at stake. Kostas Simitis went through that the first few weeks he was in government with EMEA. And I think that has a lot to do with the institutional uncertainties, with the fact that there's no clear line of authority, that there's no, like, checklist, and so on. And this is apparent when Greece faces bigger challenges. This was apparent, for example, during the Olympics. And I think the book has spent, you know, some time on this, and this is good, which is the fact that, you know, the Olympics was a huge challenge. The Greek state had to really rise way above its capabilities. It was done, but it was done because of micromanagement by the Prime Minister, and also because of external pressure. There were a lot of deadlines, tasks, and so on. Then came the debt crisis, and that has been a perpetual crisis for the last 5 years. And basically, it has really exhausted prime ministers, their staff, finance ministers, and so on, because they cannot really depend on the state or a very clear professional system to help them with this. The silver lining, of course, is that after these 5 years, there is a small cadre of civil servants in every ministry who are very good in this. I mean, when you talk to the Troika people or OECD people, they tell you that in every ministry there are 10, 15, 20 people who are really great. They really know their job. They really know what they are doing. The problem, again, is embystosyne. The new government comes in. They say, oh, well, if they work for the previous government, we cannot trust them. And then we have another learning curve. And that's a big problem. Now, let me say a couple of things about policy recommendations, because I think that's something that's also, you know, perhaps missing. I mean, that's not what an academic book is written for, but I think it's important. One thing is, it sounds trivial, but it's not. I've heard a lot of prime ministers complain about Maximou, and nobody can figure out why the prime minister's office moved from the parliament to Maximou, and when this was decided. It was during the Andreas years. But everybody complains about the fact that not only it's depressing, which is okay, but also that it's very dysfunctional, that it's not, you know, a modern prime minister's office and cannot be refigured as a modern prime minister's office just because of its layout, because it's old, and so on. And I think some people have thought about it. During the Papandreou years, I know there was a lot of discussion about this, but nothing was done. But I think this is really important. Another thing is to have permanent institutions, you know, like happens in the rest of the world, so that every prime minister, when he comes in, he knows that, you know, this is it. You cannot really change. You can change a couple of things, but you cannot change the whole structures. Number three, and I think this is very important, is to bring in more civil servants into the prime minister's office. It happens with diplomats, sometimes with members of the Symbolia Epikratias, but I think we need more of that, because it's very important to establish a bond of trust between the prime minister's office and the civil service, because there's a lot of antagonism there, a lot of friction. I would end by saying that, you know, I think a policy recommendation would be to do something very un-Greek, which will be to create like a blue ribbon commission and to have some of our former prime ministers sit down with you and try and think really hard about, you know, what needs to be changed in the prime minister's institution and the way it works. I think the book is a great contribution towards that direction, but to have such a commission, it would help a lot of the future prime ministers who never get ready in time for this to reflect, you know, before they get into that awful job. Thank you, and then we'll open up to the questions.